The path thus far for Notre Dame has been anything but smooth. But to this Irish team, every challenge is an opportunity. Last week, red-hot Arizona State had a signature victory over USC. But the Sun Devils still are approaching tonight, looking to prove something. The Shamrock Series has come to Dallas. Notre Dame and Arizona State take the Saturday night stage. Downtown Dallas, Texas, where they love their football. And in nearby Arlington is AT&T Stadium, the palatial home of the Dallas Cowboys, where tonight Notre Dame hosts a Shamrock Series game as Todd Graham brings his Arizona State Sun Devils in after a crushing win over USC. While Brian Kelly tries to refocus his Irish squad after last week's home loss to Oklahoma. The Shamrock Series, special uniforms and all, from Dallas. Hello, everyone, and welcome to Texas. Tom Hammond here for this Shamrock Series game, a home game away from home for Notre Dame. The Irish now 3-2 after that turnover-plagued loss to Oklahoma last week. And while Notre Dame was falling out of the top 25, Arizona State was climbing in thanks to that win over USC, where they scored 62 points and had over 600 yards of offense in what would prove to be Lane Kiffin's final game as USC coach. And Arizona State has a chance to make a little history today. In all the years of college football, no team has ever been able to put together back-to-back wins over USC and Notre Dame. And at the home of the Cowboys, here come the Irish. Saying his team has to focus on making the ordinary plays, which they didn't make last week against Oklahoma. And Tommy Rees, two tough games back to back, looking to bounce back as the Sun Devils of Arizona State make their appearance at AT&T Stadium. Jake Sheffield carrying the American flag, the Iraq War veteran, as Coach Todd Graham looks on. There is the American flag carried by Sheffield. And welcome back to AT&T Stadium, joined now by Mike Mayock. And Mike, it was interesting yesterday when Notre Dame had their walkthrough here. The players got their first look at the stadium. Boy, their eyes got wide. Heck, mine got wide here when I saw it as well. This is some setting.
How about the unis? I mean, these kids are loving it. If you're a 20-year-old college football player, you're in this beautiful NFL stadium, you're under the lights on national television, you better be fired up to play football tonight.
Well, you know, this Arizona State offense is fun to watch. A lot of misdirection, a lot of things trying to confuse the defense, and they have a lot of weapons.
Yeah, and my first impression, Tom, was the tempo they play at. Head coach Todd Graham said it's left lane, it's pedal to the metal, and he's absolutely right. Now, my next impression was the quality and depth of their skill position players. But finally, the guy that makes it all go is their quarterback, Taylor Kelly. Last week against USC, 62 points, over 600 yards. This kid accounted for 351 yards in the pass game, another 79 in the run game. Tom, he's one of the top dual threat quarterbacks in the country.
Well, you know, for a lot of reasons, that means that Notre Dame needs to get the running game going. Yeah.
And I think they found a little something last week. George Atkinson, 220-pound tailback, 14 carries for 148 yards. He had an 80-yard scamper, but more importantly, I think he ran physically. They've got to control the football tonight. And lastly, it's about the quarterback position. Tommy Rees has to be efficient and turnover-free.
These two teams have only played twice before, and Notre Dame won both of them, 48-17 the last time in South Bend. But Todd Graham did come into Notre Dame Stadium and beat the Irish 28-27 with the Tulsa Hurricanes. Arizona State won the toss, and they have deferred. George Atkinson deep for the Irish. And Garut, Alex Garut, to kick off for the Sun Devils. This kick is going to be fielded by Cam McDaniel, and McDaniel will bring it out to the 20-yard line, then wrestle down. Let's take a look now at our starting Notre Dame offensive lineup, brought to you by Adidas.
Tommy Reese, Lake Bluff, Illinois. I'm one of only 7 Irish quarterbacks to start as a freshman and a senior.
Chris Watt, Glen Ellen, Illinois, and I've played piano for 10 years.
George Atkinson, Stockton, California, and we like to call ourselves RBU, Running Back University.
And there's Tommy Reese. Last two games, as you see, have been a little rough after he had 3 straight 300-yard passing games. 3 interceptions last week against Oklahoma. From the pistol, Reese with a handoff to Atkinson. Bounces it outside, and Atkinson crosses the 25 before Carl Bradford forces him out. That's a gain of 4 on the first play from scrimmage.
Boy, really good cut there. Erebor, the corner, came off the edge, and he made a miss immediately.
So the Irish already back to the line of scrimmage and ready to go on 2nd down and 6. In from the pistol. Tailback is George Atkinson. Daniels in motion. Reese fumbled the snap for a moment and late getting the ball to Atkinson, who stopped in his tracks. Penetration by the Arizona State defense. A loss of 6 yards on the play. It was Demetrius Randall that made the play.
Yeah, bobbled snap while they're in the pistol formation. Didn't really disrupt the timing of the play. What disrupted the timing of the play was Randall, who's starting his first game, a junior college transfer. He's finally healthy. They think he's one of the better cover safeties around, and he'll get most of the snaps tonight.
Only 34% the last two games on 3rd down conversions. In the first possession of the game, here's a 3rd and long for the Irish. Tommy Reese changing the play. Empty backfield. Reese chased, got his man, complete to Daniels. DeVoris Daniels picks up an Irish first down. There's a 3rd down conversion for Notre Dame. It goes for 17.
Really nice job by Tommy Reese, because there was a couple of different twist stunts on inside. You're going to see the linebacker coming right up and a twist right around. Reese does a good job getting rid of the football off his back leg. DeVoris Daniels, who needs to be more productive on a short crossing route. Arizona State misses more tackles than maybe any team I've seen in the country this year.
Reese with Atkinson next to him, changing the play.
As is Arizona State. They blitz more than any team in the country off the edge.
Reese drills it between defenders to Nicholas, the tight end. Chris Young stopped him after a gain of 10. I'm not sure how he got that ball in there.
Yeah, and he was in line. Troy Nicholas is in line next to the tackle. You could see the outside release. Now use that big body of yours. The ball was put perfectly in between Stephon Martin and the outside linebacker Chris Young. Good throw and catch. I think that's what Tommy Reese does well. Those kind of throws. And those kind of reads.
Draw play handoff to Amir Carlisle, who's into the game for the first time. Carlisle with a 4-yard carry.
And Tom, in today's age of pinball college offenses where you throw it 50 and 60 times, and let's face it, Tommy Reese has thrown the ball an awful lot in his 4 years. If you're a Notre Dame fan, this is the offense you're looking for tonight. Control the football, control the clock, keep Arizona State off the field, but at the end of these drives, you've got to get touchdowns.
Another 3rd down for the Irish. Atkinson stacked up short of the 1st down and thrown back by the ASU defense, led by Coleman. Now 4th down.
This drive has already had about 9 or 10 run attempts in it.
So a field goal attempt from Kyle Brinza. Brinza will attempt a 38-yarder. He's hit 5 of 7 field goals, as long as 44. From 38, Brinza to give the Irish the lead. And badly hooked to the left.
Oh, is that ugly?
So the Irish had an impressive drive, converting several crucial plays, but it comes up empty. Todd Graham and the Sun Devils get their chance on offense when we come back to Dallas. And so Taylor Kelly gets his first chance in this game tonight, the quarterback of Arizona State, as we meet the starting lineups for the ASU offense.
Taylor Kelly, Boise, Idaho. I like to race cars and ride horses.
Evan Fingerbird, Cota de Casa, California. I can throw a 91-mile-per-hour fastball.
Marion Grice, Houston, Texas. I have a pit bull named Cash.
So Arizona State pass to D.J. Foster and wrestled down at the 25-yard line by Jalen Smith.
Now let's see how quickly they decide to go here. Looking to the sideline. So this isn't NASCAR. This isn't their fastest speed right now.
On second and six, here's Kelly. Pass is caught short of the 30-yard line by Foster again. Jared Gray stopped in that time, a gain of five.
Okay, they're looking over the sideline now. All the signals are being sent in. Same thing at Notre Dame, looking at their sideline.
Third down and six. Grice next to Kelly. Flag down. And the pass to Grice is complete for an Arizona State first down to the 45-yard line, where he's tackled by Jarrett Grace. That's a 10-yard gain.
And that's a win for ASU. If they get Grice on Grace, it's a win.
Spot the ball on the Irish 23-yard line. Arizona State first down, 22 seconds to go, opening quarter. Still no points on the board. Quarterback draw. Kelly inside the Irish 20.
Bennett Jackson's got to make that tackle. He's Notre Dame's boundary corner. Had a pretty easy shot at it and missed the tackle. Can't just throw at his feet. You got to wrap up and tackle.
6-yard gain on what will be the final play of the first quarter. So the first quarter comes to a close with Notre Dame nothing, Arizona State nothing, but the Sun Devils driving. We'll return to AT&T Stadium after these messages from your local NBC station. You're watching Notre Dame football on NBC. Tom Hammond, Mike Mayock, Alex Flanagan ready to start the second quarter at AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas. The Shamrock Series game between Notre Dame and Arizona State. Sun Devils with a drive getting deep into Notre Dame territory, but there's D.J. Foster taken down by Jalen Smith, and the freshman made a terrific play. Jalen Smith for a loss of six.
Does a nice job beating Chris Coyle. Watch him beat the tight end. 87 is going to try and block him. He flashes, beats him with great speed, and makes the tackle. That's why they're so excited about this freshman.
So third down and 10. Kelly is 7 for 7 passing so far in this game.
I'd say alert into the boundary here. Alert 21 strong down here.
Kelly goes that way, and Strong is ruled out of bounds and incomplete, defended by Bennett Jackson.
Every time there's a safety in the middle of the field up here that can't help out, Bennett Jackson's one-on-one, and you've got to be physical because Strong is 6'3", 205 pounds, and one of the best receivers in the nation. You've got to match physicality with physicality. The kid's not going to beat you deep with speed, but boy, does he have a big body and an efficient ability to catch the football.
Zane Gonzalez lines up for a 40-yard field goal attempt. Gonzalez puts it on its way, and it is through the uprights and good. So Arizona State with the first points of the game. They lead Notre Dame 3-0. Garut will kick off for Arizona State. George Atkinson, as usual, is deep for the Irish. 3-0 Sun Devils. Short kick taken by Atkinson. Crossing the 20. Has a block on the edge. And ridden out of bounds just short of the 40-yard line. Nice return by George Atkinson. Off to McDaniel, and he'll pick up an Irish first down. First down, Cam McDaniel, who has more carries than any other Irish running back, gains five on that one before Fiso stops him.
And McDaniel's a kid from the state of Texas who is their most dependable ball carrier. Also a guy they use to finish games when they're ahead and they want to run out the clock. I think, Tom, he's got a little bit of a chip on his shoulder because I think he feels he can be more explosive, but is not used in that role.
All-state at Capel High School here in Texas, gained 1,900 yards and scored 32 touchdowns this senior season. Atkinson, nowhere to go. He dropped for a loss of one.
Good tackle by the corner, Irabor. I think their better players are into the boundary. And, Tom, you know, in college football, not like the pros, with the hash marks, you've got a definitive field and a short field. And a lot of college teams put their better defensive backs into the boundary because teams like to run there. And that kid's a tough kid. I think he's a draftable defensive back. A lot of the scouts have told me he's a mid-round guy.
Sets up second and 11 for Tommy Reese, who changes the play again. Incomplete as Arizona State once again came with pressure. Darby was in there in the backfield. Bradford was too.
Bradford is so quick, and there's a little bit of a disconnect between the left guard, Chris Watt. Watt's got to get out here because you're going to see the tackle turn. Once that tackle turns out, he's got to turn also. The left tackle, Zach Martin, does a good job picking up the blitz. Chris Watt's got to be more quick than that.
Third down and 11.
And Tom, they have to finish drives with points. The game plan's working well for Notre Dame, but they haven't finished.
Empty backfield, third down and 11. Blitz comes. Picked up by Notre Dame, but the pass is broken up by Darby, intended for Daniels.
Really good coverage by Alden Darby, who is their boundary safety. Ball was thrown a little bit behind, but there was good coverage everywhere. Watch him pick the blitz up. Nice job by the offensive line. Now the crossing route's behind, and Darby strips it easily.
Darby with 8 career interceptions. He had one for a 46-yard touchdown this season. Fourth down and 11, and the Irish in punt formation again. Wolfick boots it. Fair catch called and made by Nelson at about the 11-yard line. Punt covered 27 with no return. Arizona State deep in their own territory, but up by 3 on the Irish. So from the 11-yard line, first down for the Sun Devils in the shotgun. Kelly, good protection. Dumped it off short, and the ball falls incomplete, intended for Coyle. Chris Coyle, who had a reception earlier, which was his 12th of the season, had a big game against USC.
Yeah, he had 57 catches a year ago. He was the guy that was really happy when Todd Graham got here and started throwing the football.
There's a handoff to Bryce. Bryce able to turn the corner. Crosses the 20-yard line before he is ridden out of bounds by Austin Collinsworth. A gain of 11.
Oh, man.
And first down, ASU.
Tom, we just said what a great job Jalen Smith, the freshman linebacker, did. And now watch him right here. He's going to get crushed. That was Nelson, the tight end H-back, who cracks back on him. He had contained, loses it, and they get outside for a first down. Trials and tribulations of being a true freshman, Thomas. Trust me, that kid's so gifted, it's crazy. But teams are attacking him because he doesn't process as quickly as a veteran.
So now from the 22, first down, ASU. Coyle. 6-yard gain on the pass from Kelly, who's having a big first half.
I think the big thing, Tom, for the Notre Dame defense is not giving up big plays. Last week against Oklahoma, uncharacteristically, a couple of big pass plays. And today, against this great Arizona offense, we've got to keep everything in front.
Kelly's hit 9 of 11 passes here in the first half. Another one upcoming. Chased from the pocket. He'll pick up a first down as he rambles around the outside. And Jackson makes sure he goes out of bounds But another nice run by Taylor Kelly, who is a dual threat quarterback. He gains 15 with his feet.
Yeah, nice job. Notre Dame only rushed three. They dropped eight. Kelly saw it. He also saw Jalen Smith turn his back, and he got out the gate.
The shotgun. On the option, hands to Grice. Short gain for Marion.
They're doing a fine job on the zone read. That's the rage right now in college football and also in the NFL. And so far, the discipline has been exceptional by Notre Dame's front.
Under center this time. Play action fake. Kelly whips it downfield. And it's caught by Strong. Jalen Strong to the Irish 25-yard line. That's a gain of 28 yards before Kavari Russell stops him.
And this is who Jalen Strong is. Man coverage on Collinsworth. Look at the size. I think his strong hands are what differentiates him from other big receivers.
ASU ready to go. On the first down play. Off the hands of the intended receiver, Cameron Smith.
That, Thomas, is a beautiful throw. Cameron Smith should have caught that football. I really think Taylor Kelly, they do the back shoulder fade as well as any college team I've ever seen.
Todd Graham telling us, so did Mike Norvell, the Texas native who is the offensive coordinator, that they work constantly on that back shoulder throw. Fake to Grice. Kelly chased from the pocket. Nicks in pursuit. And he finds a receiver. It's Cameron Smith again. Let's see where they mark his forward progress. Looked like about a 9-yard gain.
Yeah, Taylor Kelly's the difference in this game. Nice job. Keeps his composure. Cameron Smith, the true freshman. Tom, he's in the game because they say he might be the fastest player on Arizona State's team, which is really saying something.
He's another Texan from Coppell, Texas, the same hometown as Cam McDaniel, Notre Dame. High formation this time.
Okay. They've got a matchup at the bottom of the screen. They may look.
Third down and three for Graham's Sun Devils.
Big
Grice
play.
And tailback in the eye. Fake it to him. Kelly still has it. And he falls down. He slips and falls at the 10-yard line with Jalen Smith in hot pursuit. That's a loss of six, and the Notre Dame defense holds on third down.
Jalen Smith looks like a traffic cop here. Watch him make up speed. He starts to come in, sees the bootleg. Now he makes a cut and turns. He tracks him down like a state trooper. That is great natural ability, loose hips, and a huge play by Jalen Smith.
So Fernandez or Gonzalez, who already has a field goal tonight, will attempt a 27-yarder. He hit from 40 earlier. This one from 27. Gonzalez. No problem. Boots it through the uprights. And Graham and the Sun Devils go up 6-0 on Kelly and the Irish. Back in the Dallas Metroplex area. Good job by the Notre Dame defense there, holding the Sun Devils to a field goal. But Arizona State leading 6-0. Garut with the kickoff. Another short.
That's on purpose, away from Atkinson.
It's to McDaniel. And he's rocked at about the 27-yard line. Notre Dame had pretty good field position the two possessions before this, each at the 39-yard line. So a little tougher task here, and they still don't have any points. Under pressure, Reese may get rid of it to Nicholas. And Nicholas will have an Irish first down as he crosses the 45-yard line. An 18-yard gain. Martin hanging on to the big tight end. 6'6", 220. But what a play by Tommy Reese.
Yeah, and I really think they have to continue to utilize. I mean, you look at this 6'7", 260-pound specimen. Is he a vertical threat? Probably not. But what he is, short and intermediate, if you get the ball on his body, he's going to catch it. And they need to utilize him in the middle of the field more often.
Reese took the hit and delivered the strike. There's a first down pass. Had a man open and he has him. That is TJ Jones. And Jones with another Irish first down. That one covers 15.
Yeah, and I like the timing there. Tommy Reese got it out just in time. Good route by Jones, and they move the sticks again.
First down play from the pistol formation.
Got to be alert every snap of Irabor, the boundary corner coming. There he is.
Handed off to Atkinson. Tough run by Atkinson, and pretty productive one at that on first down, as Gannon Conway stacks him up after a gain of six.
It's one of the things that Tommy Reese is looking at, along with his tackles, Tom. It's interesting. You see their tackles head on a swivel. They know how much blitz you get off the slot and into the boundary from the corner. So the tackles and Tommy Reese are especially watching for those blitzes. Comes another up. See, there's that's here before. They love bringing him. Now he might not come. They might check out of it, but they love to bring that kid.
All kinds of movement. No flags. Hand wide open. And over his head and incomplete. It was Chris Brown.
Wow. And there were a bunch of busts that Arizona State had last week. Look, here comes the corner here trying to jump what he thought was probably going to be a bubble screen. The safety Randall had to come over the top, and the ball was too high, overthrown, and that was an opportunity to make a play. The corner was coming, and the safety had to come over top.
Third and four, two tight ends for the Irish. Running back is McDaniel. Reese is going to go to the air, and he delivers, and it's caught. T.J. Jones with another clutch reception, takes three to bring him down, but he has a first for the Irish, gain of 13.
And again, Irabor coming from the boundary, a nice job. Watch them pick him up here, and Tommy Reese will slide this way and make a good throw. They pick up the corner, he slides to his left. The timing is good, man coverage. That's a good-looking play right there. Good timing. Arizona State's going to challenge you all day long with man coverage, and you better win.
First down, Irish. Again, man's wide open. It's Koyak, the tight end, for the touchdown.
The corner comes again, Irabor. And the linebacker Fiso is going to fall down while he covers Koyak. Here comes the corner off the edge. They pick that up. There's the throw. Fiso, 58, fell down. Koyak finishes. Well-orchestrated drive.
Ben Koyak's first reception of the season is a 19-yard touchdown, and the Brinza extra point just sneaks inside the upright to give the Irish the lead. That was a drive that looked good and then resulted in points. Koyak from Reese. Extra point makes it 7-6 Irish. Brinza will kick off. Bryce is deep for Arizona State. With 3:35 left till halftime, Notre Dame has its first lead. Here's Bryce. Across the 20 to about the 22-yard line. Slam down there. Play action fake. Kelly on target to Foster. First down before he's shoved out of bounds by Jalen Smith. That's a 14-yard gain as Kelly's right back to work.
And that's a guy, DJ Foster, I think they got to get him more touches. Now, we talk about Marion Grice, potential All-American, but this kid here catches the ball. They can detach him. They can put him in the backfield. They got to find him more touches.
Fake to Grice. Kelly chased from the pocket. Remember, he can run. And there he goes. Ducks out of bounds a couple of yards short of first down yardage.
Stephon Tuitt, again, a guy that's got to make plays for Notre Dame. A lot of people, me including, think he has played heavy-legged this year. He was a little bit heavy early in the season. He had off-season surgery. If this kid wants to be a high pick in the draft, he's got to be in shape and make plays.
Second and two. Foster. Well done. Jalen Smith just able to trip him up. Another ASU first down. That one went for 15 yards. And Taylor Kelly is on target tonight.
Yeah, that's just a halfback screen. They love that play. They get him the ball out there, and both the tight end and wide receiver did a great job staying in the blocks.
ASU coming right back after Notre Dame took the lead. They're in Irish territory. The action fake. Kelly rips it down the sideline, and it is caught or not. Still waiting for the official to say whether he was out of bounds or inbounds. It's incomplete. Kevin Ozier.
At the very end here, Collinsworth with good coverage. Look at the one hand.
Yeah, catch. Nice.
He doesn't have the ball and securely till he's way out of bounds. But boy, that's a great effort by Ozier.
Second down and 10. Kelly, open is strong. Bring up a third down for ASU.
Kid Strong came a long way to Arizona State. He started out at West Catholic High School in West Philadelphia. Had quite the odyssey to get here.
Had a troubled upbringing. His dad died when he was very young and got in a little trouble here and there and has turned it around. Irish showing a blitz. Third down and 4. And Taylor Kelly will change the play.
And so will Notre Dame. They just changed it. Danny Fox made the call. Pushing Calabrese up into the guard tackle gap.
Here they come. Kelly downfield. Some contact downfield between Strong, the intended receiver, and Elijah Shoemate defending, but incidental contact.
Yeah, Shoemate's got to find the football here. He's on the slot. Trail technique. Now, when that ball's in the air, you better get your head around because, for the most part, referees will call that interference if you don't turn and look for the football.
Fourth down and 4. ASU is going for it.
Can't jump off sides here. Okay, they scan to their sideline. You scan to your sideline. Look at everybody at Notre Dame looking left. The Arizona State guys looking to their left.
The Sun Devils have used all their timeouts and are about to get a delayed game. Just got it off. Fourth down and 4, going for the end zone and caught by Strong. Touchdown, Sun Devils.
Jalen Strong won at the line of scrimmage. He beat Austin Collinsworth off the line. Watch how quickly he wins here. It's over. If I'm even, I'm leaving. Beautiful throw, but Jalen Strong won that early.
Remember, this was a fourth down play, fourth and 4, and they nearly had a delay of game.
Took them a while to finally secure the football, but that is a wonderful throw and a heck of a catch.
36-yard score. Gonzalez adds the extra point. So Arizona State answers the Notre Dame score with a 7-play, 78-yard drive kept alive on that 4th and 4, 36-yard touchdown pass to Jalen Strong.
And again, away from Atkinson.
Short kick to McDaniel. Driven out of bounds short of the 30-yard line. Clock down to 1:01. Now rolling inside 1 minute. Play clock. Plenty of time, 10 seconds. Tommy Reese over the head of his intended receiver Daniels. Once again, they misconnect receiver and quarterback.
I've been impressed with Notre Dame's offensive line, Tom, and the way they've picked up a variety of blitzes and stunts. We saw it on tape. We heard the coaches talk about it. I've never seen a team blitz more off the edge than Arizona State.
I sure keep you guessing, keep you on your toes as to what they're going to do. Reese puts it down the sideline and is caught. Fingertip catch made by T.J. Jones. Beautifully done by the Irish as Jones beat Randall for 34 yards.
This time I like the throw and the route because it gets back outside the numbers. Free safety can't get there. T.J. Jones does a great job of stacking the corner. Once he beats him, Look at him get on top of the corner. The ball's perfectly thrown. Robert Nelson has no chance, and the safety can't get there.
First down at the 26-yard line of Arizona State. Pressure on Reese, who unloads it. Incomplete. Good decision. Coleman was in his chops. So 35 seconds remaining.
And again, Troy Nicholas is doing a better job of being physical in the middle of the field. I think Tommy Reese has got to look for him. He's attacking linebackers. He's getting open. This is the area of the field where you've got to take advantage of a guy that looks like, I don't know, Superman, 6'7", 260. Boy, is he put together. Lined up in line.
Second down and 10. Good protection. Reese, crossing route is complete to Daniels, just tripped up at the 3-yard line.
Well, a few times they're in a zone coverage. They're in a 2-deep zone that time. Nicholas ran up the chute, and Daniels came in from the far side. Beautifully constructed and beautifully thrown.
Gain of 22 yards. First and goal, Irish. Blitz coming. Jones, T.J. Jones with a touchdown, his fourth touchdown reception of the season, as Notre Dame picked up the blitz and Jones was wide open in the end zone. So after the offense has sputtered a little bit to score touchdowns early, we've gone bang, bang, bang. So the band of the Fighting Irish was something to celebrate. They're already on the field ready for their halftime show. And just 10 seconds remaining as Brinza lines up for the extra point. And he's got it. Notre Dame back in front by one. Let's go to Alex with Coach Kelly.
So, Coach, you had trouble finishing the first couple of drives. How important was it to finish this last one?
Well, it's exactly right. I mean, missed field goal on the first one. We've moved the ball effectively, but we just haven't put points on the board, and that's been kind of our deal. And it was good to come back here with a minute 30 to go and finish a good drive.
This ASU team, I think, is averaging 44 points. Are you content right now to have held them to 13?
Well, we played pretty good defense. I think the way the game is going, we've had that long drive in the first quarter. We've kept them off the field. I think that's part of this game as well. They're a very good offense. I think as we get into the second half, they get the first possession. I think the third quarter is going to be huge.
All right, Coach, thank you.
Stay tuned for the Discover Card halftime report. Don't forget the halftime performances of the bands are at NBCSports.com as we go to Carolyn Mano now in our NBC studio. From deep in the heart of Texas, Big D, Dallas, where Notre Dame leads Arizona State 14-13 in the Shamrock Series game at AT&T Stadium. And welcome inside our stadium here to our booth where, what about all that noise we made about Notre Dame having to run the football?
Well, we set it all up, said they had to run the football. They ran it 15 times. Tommy Reese threw it 24 times. And on those last two drives, he was 8-for-14 for two touchdowns.
For the first half stats, 209 total yards for ASU, 245 for Notre Dame. Remember, Arizona State had 612 against USC for the game last week.
And more importantly, Tom, what, 62 points?
Yeah, 62 points. Wow. Todd Graham and his Sun Devils trailing by one here at halftime. They will get the ball to open the third quarter. Both offenses coming alive in the latter stages of that first half, and chiefly through the air. Brinza will kick for Notre Dame, and Marion Grice is the deep man for the Sun Devils. In a one-point game. Brinza drives it into the end zone for the touchback. Let's check in with Alex Flanagan.
So, Tom, you and Mike talking about the 62 points that ASU put up on USC a week ago. Not nearly as explosive tonight. Todd Graham telling me at halftime that's because Notre Dame has done a great job of stopping his tempo offense. They're not playing nearly as fast as they'd like to be. This ASU team typically averages about 81 plays per game. They had 34 plays on offense in the first half. They'd like to play faster in the second half. And Todd Graham reminding me, you guys, that his team is a second half team.
All right, ready to start that second half then from the 25-yard line. Kelly, wide open is strong, goes to the turf to make the catch at around the 30-yard line. So gain of 5 on first down.
Yeah, a little bit of a sloppy start there. That was wide open. Kavari Russell really played soft there on the corner.
Designed keep by Kelly. Well, one of the things that Nix is called on to do, isn't it, is to take up space and occupy more than one blocker.
And it's exactly right, and that's what he's done. And I sense a little frustration talking to him a couple of weeks ago. No sacks, not a lot of tackles. He knows he's doing a good job. Bob Diaco told me before the game he thought he had one of his best games last week against Oklahoma.
Third down and 5. Checking the sideline.
Both teams scanning.
Taylor Kelly steps up in the pocket. His pass is deflected and incomplete. Romeo Okwuoru.
Yeah, Romeo Okwuoru, who they use in their nickel and sub packages. Watch what he does. He's just going to scan. He's going to hit the offensive lineman. Then he's going to back off. Eyes on quarterback, scan, and knock it down. Nice play by Okwuoru.
So a good series for the Notre Dame defense to open the third quarter. And here's Hawk to punt. TJ Jones makes a fair catch at about the 22-yard line. Of course, Todd Graham knows all about playing Notre Dame. 3 years ago, he took an underdog Tulsa team into South Bend, and he would pull off the big upset. Late in the second quarter, a Tommy Reese pass intercepted, returned 66 yards for a touchdown to pull Tulsa to within 2 at 20-18. Then with Notre Dame trailing 28-27, time running out, Reese intercepted again, this time looking for Michael Floyd in the end zone. The Hurricanes completed one of the biggest upsets the 2010 college football season. Hand off to George Atkinson on first down to the 25-yard line. So there is Todd Graham, who has made some stops. He is from Mesquite, Texas, as we told you. He played at East Central University in Oklahoma, then went to Rice as an assistant coach and then the head coach. To Tulsa as the head coach, to Pitt one season as head coach before coming to Arizona State and really started to turn them around last year.
Yeah, I told him as a former defensive player, I would hate to play against his offense, and he laughed. He said, you know, when we designed this offense, it was all.
Reese down the sideline. A lot of pushing and shoving, and Jones makes the catch. TJ Jones finally spun down by Demarius Randall, but a big gain that time. 37 yards as Jones just outfought Randall for the possession.
He's having a big game out here now. He had 5 catches for 71 in the first half. Excuse me, good coverage. But Jones sees the football, comes back to it, and finishes the run physically.
It was actually Nelson defending him there. And a physical play by TJ Jones for the big gain.
Corner.
First and 15 run by Atkinson to the 40-yard line. Almost the 40 anyway.
Again, Tom, back to the run game a little bit like the first half started. And we talked about how the pass game developed, and I really do believe that they softened them up a little bit early in the game. Run, 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 and then they got to the pass attack. And I'm sure you're going to see it again. You're talking about second and 13 or 14 right now.
Here's Amir Carlisle into the game. set by Reese to the tailback spot. Blitz off the slot from the pistol. Carlisle gets the handoff, lowers his head and pounds his way to the 35-yard line. Carl Bradford stops him after five.
Nickel stays on that block a little longer. They might have something big there, but at least it gets them back into a third and under 10 situation. Arizona State, heavy substitution right now.
Third down and eight, third and long for the Irish. In Sun Devil territory, early third quarter.
Pretty good job with Carl Bradford tonight, who comes off the edge right here.
Reese got good protection. His pass, though, off target, intended for Carlisle. It'll bring up a fourth down.
Again, good protection for Tommy Reese. It's kind of no man's land,
yeah,
right, Tom?
Yeah, it's too far for a field goal, too close for a punt, unless you just try to pooch it.
Yeah, and I think that's probably what we're looking at here.
Brenza is going to attempt a field goal, apparently.
Mm. So he hooked the first one badly from a lot shorter. He does have a strong leg.
52 in pregame. This is 53 yards. Brenza from 53. On its way, and it is good. Kyle Brenza with a career-long field goal. 53 yards to extend the Irish lead. Irish up their lead now to 17-14 after the Brenza career-long field goal. He's ready to kick it off. Brenza boots it deep into the end zone where Bryce will down it. So Arizona State gets the football at the 19-yard line. Hand off to Bryce, who draws a crowd and stops short of the 20-yard line.
Okay, here they go quickly again. They got three receivers into the boundary, one receiver to the field.
High snap. Smith. Ball came loose. Picked up by Notre Dame by Dan Fox. Bennett Jackson making the play for Notre Dame.
If Jackson's being blocked by Nelson, does a really good job getting back into it. Here's Jackson. He's going to get blocked by number 12, Nelson. The right arm strips. Ball clearly out. Danny Fox with the recovery.
First turnover of the game by either team.
Well, that's a heck of a play by Bennett Jackson. Right on the football.
Forces the fumble. Fox recovers. Notre Dame has it at the 21-yard line of Arizona State. Approaching 4 minutes in the third quarter. Tommy Reese scrambling. Had a man wide open. The pass was incomplete. It was too low for Chris Brown.
Yeah, and good job by Tommy Reese, but he does a good job stepping up and through the pocket. Now, our Doug Flutie did this for a living. Watch him step up and through, but where the Flutie disconnect happens is right there. Tommy Reese can't throw on the run. And of course, our Doug Flutie won a Heisman because of his ability to do it.
There's Chris Brown checking the play call on his belt.
Tommy Reese is saying, you're on the wrong side while you're reading the paperwork, freshman.
Grabbed by Nicholas for the touchdown. it for the extra point. And it is good. The only turnover of the game, converted into a touchdown by the Irish.
Veteran quarterback understanding a situation here in the red zone. They're bringing pressure off the slot. Tommy Reese rolls to his left, and now it's all about giving your 6'7" tight end an opportunity to win a jump ball against the 5'11" safety Alden Darby. Rolling to his left, comes all the way back to Nicholas. Here's the jump ball. Look at the size difference. Wow.
It up to kick it off as the Irish extend their lead now to 24-13. 3:54 to go, third quarter. Again, he buries it in the end zone where Grice will down it. And Grice, shaking tacklers, dives across the 30-yard line. Eliza Shoemate covers him at that point. Sacks. Taylor Kelly. Second sack for Prince Shembo.
Zero sacks all season, 14 in his career. Two more give him 16. The tailback comes over late, doesn't pick him up. Shembo comes off the edge. Second big play of the evening.
DJ Foster, gain of 10.
Good play by Arizona State. Gets it back into a very makeable third down situation. And I don't think they're going to panic. Okay, there's a run box right now, which means that there's two high safeties, and now Notre Dame's going to get out of it.
Defense reacts in a hurry, and that's a short gain of a yard or two, and Bennett Jackson leading the charge for the Notre Dame defense.
And I think his most aggressive game of the year so far. Does a nice job running through a block to make the tackle. And if I'm Notre Dame here, I'm alert, punt safe.
Hawk to punt it. Jones, fair catch call. Made at the 25-yard line. McDaniel cuts up. A couple of tough yards to the 30. Clock rolls inside a minute. Davin Coleman made the tackle for the Sun Devils.
Yeah, pretty good battle there with Troy Nicholas and Carl Bradford.
Seconds ticking away for the third quarter. That's the end of the third with Notre Dame leading 24-13. Back to AT&T Stadium after these messages from your local NBC station. You're watching Notre Dame football on NBC. Ready to start the fourth quarter. Late in the second, Arizona State led 13-7. But since then, Notre Dame has scored 17 unanswered. Start the fourth. The Irish up 24-13.
Anthony Jones coming off the edge. Picked up beautiful.
Intercepted. Erebor with the interception. Still going. Picking up blockers. And will score the touchdown.
Great play. Now we've talked all night about Tommy Reese in the pocket. Making good decisions. This one isn't. Erebor squats on this route.
Yard return for the touchdown. Erebor's second interception of the season, the sixth of his career. puts Arizona State right back in it.
And Anthony Jones is going to come off the edge in a little stunt. They pick it up beautifully, but Tommy Reese throws the ball with a hang corner. Erebor sees it the whole way, drives on it, then becomes a running back. And that's a great return and gets Arizona State right back in this football game. Great play by Erebor.
Here's the extra point attempt by Gonzalez. And he puts it through. So the first Notre Dame turnover results instantly in an ASU touchdown. Will Sutton's left hand getting some attention on the ASU bench. As Garoot kicks off, taken at the goal line by McDaniel. Cam will make it only to the 20 before he's stopped with the special teams of the Sun Devils. So Tommy Reese right back to action. George Atkinson. Nice run on first down. Got him 8 yards, 9 yards. Now Carl Bradford and Demarius Randall tackling him.
It'd be interesting to see how Tommy Reese and the Irish handle this adversity. Remember, turnovers have been Tommy Reese's Achilles heel since his freshman year.
Two tight ends. Hand it off. Atkinson bounces to the outside. Shakes a tackle. Keeps his balance with his hand down and picks up a first down. Stopped by Martin after a gain of 5.
I really didn't like the bounce to the outside here. We're talking about running more physically. Watch what happens. We're going to get a pulling guard right up here. Lombard. Make the cut to the right there. If he cuts to the right, he still might be running.
Behind the block of Lombard. Instead of in front of him.
Yeah, exactly. Lombard made the block. It was sealed. If he takes his 220 pounds and his 10, 300 meter speed up the field, he still is running.
On the ground to McDaniel. Gain of 3.
Well, Tom, we talked at halftime how they threw the ball 24 times and ran it 15 in the first half. And we talked at the very beginning of the show that Tommy Reese had to be efficient and turnover free. He's been most of that tonight.
Sets up for the pistol on second down and hands it off to McDaniel again. McDaniel breaks free. McDaniel down the sideline and bumped out of bounds by Randall. In his homecoming, McDaniel, who seems to be shaken up with a big 28-yard jaunt.
Troy Nicholas does a heck of a job allowing the cutback. Watch Nicholas back in here stay on his man. McDaniel's going to press it front side, cut it all the way back. Nicholas stays on his man. The missed tackle. And I like how McDaniel finishes the run.
Leading to the crown of the helmet there, isn't it?
Well, I think that's
Atkinson. Nice run by George Atkinson. So the Irish coming right back with a nice drive put together. Blitz coming.
Ball, Tom.
Reese out of the end zone where Jones makes the catch, but out of bounds. Incomplete.
Throwing that one away. Ronnie Stanley picked up the blitz. It's Anthony Jones. They're in field goal territory here.
Leading by 4.
Obviously a senior quarterback wants to protect 3 points. Third and very short here.
Short of the first down, he'll be just short of the 15.
There's some bad timing there. Left tackle Zach Martin. It's Martin's going to hinge back, protect his inside. I don't like the cut again by Atkinson. I don't know why on third and inches he's bouncing the thing behind his tackle when the tackle is clearly walling off the defensive end and inviting the back inside.
So Brinza will line up for the field goal attempt from 33 yards. And it is up and it is good. The third field goal of the game for Kyle Brinza, including a record 53-yarder. That one puts them up by 7. Grade you give the Notre Dame all white with the green shoes and the gold numbers. Numbers are hard to read from up high, I'll tell you that.
Yeah, I give them an F because of that, Tom, because it's all about us.
All right.
Darn it.
What about the ASU?
You know, I talked to Todd Graham before the game and I commented on that. He said, Mike, it's all about the recruiting and the young guys love these type of uniforms and helmets.
Kyle Brinza, who a moment ago got his second field goal in 3 attempts in this game, kicks off into the end zone where Grice downs it. First down, ASU, 25-yard line. High snap. Kelly has it. Chased. Unloads. Got his man. Again, it's Jalen Strong. That's his 8th catch of the game. He had that one for 23 yards.
Yeah, that was Jalen Strong from the inside position running a wheel route, which is effectively an out and up. The corner from Notre Dame, which I believe was Kavari Russell, chased the post inside. He's wide open.
And a high snap. Handoff to Grice. Tries to go the other way. Chased, got away from another tackler, but can't turn the corner. Nice open field tackle made by Kavari Russell.
Two things there, Thomas. One, they set an edge. And two, the pursuit and speed of Notre Dame's defense was evident. We talked about Oklahoma's team speed. Notre Dame at the skill positions on both sides of the ball can run.
No gain on the play. Second down and 10. Picked up by ASU. Salka recovered it after Tuitt had knocked it free.
Tuitt working on Salka. He's going to cleanly beat Salka to the outside. Uses good hand movement, hit and strip. Salka alertly picks it up. He should have, because he's the guy that was responsible for the strip sack in the first place. I always love seeing the big fatties running with the football.
So now third down and 24.
We're going to drop 8 here.
Third down and 20. Kelly scrambling. Pass is caught. Just shy of the 30-yard line by Ozier. He beat Farley for 31 yards. And on a third and very long, Arizona State converts.
Poor coordination between the second level of linebackers and the third level of defensive backs. Nice job by ASU.
Kelly going for Coyle. Can't quite reach it.
You're going to see on the previous play, Ishaq Williams is deep. This is him here. He's got to keep going back as a tight end. Look at him. He's in there with the middle linebackers. He doesn't continue to sink back, and the corner never gets over. And there's Coyle, the tight end, right down the seam. Danny Fox, who's one of the better cover linebackers they have, in his hip pocket.
Second and 10, the running play to Grice. And he turns the corner. Wrestled out, shy of the 20-yard line by Collinsworth.
Demarie Nelson, the H-back, has been making a living on the edges, crackback blocking. Watch him come in right there. Edge of the screen.
Grice gained 11. Arizona State driving now just shy of the Notre Dame 20. First down. Taylor Kelly has caught for the touchdown by Nelson.
I watched their tape all week, and in the red zone they love running wheel routes into the boundary. Here comes Nelson in motion. He's just going to run a wheel route. Out and up. Farley doesn't get over the top. And when he does, a poor attempt at a tackle. Nice structure to the play. They make this extra point. We get a tie ball game, folks.
Gonzalez sets up to do just that. And it is good. 20 37-27 with 8:18 on the clock in the Shamrock Classic. Back at AT&T Stadium, the Shamrock Classic, Arizona State and Notre Dame. Sun Devils just tying it at 27 with 8:18 remaining on the clock. George Atkinson is the deep man for the Irish. As Garut kicks it off. This will be McDaniel. There's a flag down as McDaniel broke free for a moment and crosses the 30-yard line. Reese steps up in the pocket and has Jones again. Just short of the 35-yard line, another first down. Erebor slams him down after 14.
I like the subtle move in the pocket again. He's going to feel pressure from this side. Watch him. He's looking left. Now he just slides a little right, resets his feet, finds T.J. Jones yet again. This is outside of that one pick six. This is as impressive a night as I've seen Tommy Reese have.
135 yards receiving for T.J. Jones. They hand it to McDaniel. Another tough run by Cam. Tackled by Stephon Martin.
Yeah, and Tom, that's a good point by you. Remember on that last series, George Atkinson, who's a home run hitter, a couple of times I said he should have just honked it up in there. That time, the guard Lombard pulls, and that's what McDaniels does. Gets tough yards, moves the chains for you.
Spot the football at the 30 of Arizona State. These two teams have been going back and forth. Now under 6 minutes.
Anthony Jones, he's looking to go here again. There he goes.
And head to McDaniel. Turns the corner. McDaniel comes back again, still turning his feet, and turns inside the 20 down to the 17-yard line, where Darby stops him after 12 yards.
Darby missed the tackle and then came back in and jumped on him. But watch the speed and then the cut. And I think Cam McDaniel's making a case. Here's the cut. Darby misses him. I think McDaniel's making a case to Brian Kelly that, look, I know these other guys might have more impressive speed than I do, but I understand how to run, and I'm pretty talented myself.
62 yards on the previous 10 already. 73 on the last two drives. On the ground again to McDaniel. Look at him go through a hole and just tripped up as he falls inside the 10-yard line. Thought he had the score. You can see by his body language and just tripped up.
Yeah, Ronnie Stanley and Christian Lombard did a heck of a job. What a homecoming for this kid, huh?
Capel, Texas.
Yeah, it's called an outside zone. It's just zone blocking. Demarius Randall gets a piece of the ankle. He's going, oh, man, I thought I had it.
11 carries, 81 yards for Cam McDaniel. First down and goal. Why not? McDaniel, he's inside the 5-yard line.
This is one of those nights to me that if Notre Dame were to win the football game, I'd be in there giving Harry Heastand and that offensive line a game ball. And I'd be patting Cam McDaniel on the top of the helmet, too.
And Cam with a career high in rushing tonight.
Harry Heastand, former offensive line coach for the Chicago Bears. Quite the technician. His players love him.
Stop him for a loss in the play.
Yeah, Demarius Randall, the field safety, does a really nice job there. Because remember, Notre Dame's trying to run clock. And Randall's going to do a nice job. Randall's going to come from the inside, flash right here, and make the tackle.
McDaniel out of the game now, replaced by Amir Carlisle. Down
thinking this guy right here in the end zone and a jump ball might make some sense. And he's going to block.
Reese goes for the end zone. Collision incomplete, intended for DeVaris Daniels, defended by Lloyd Carrington.
Yeah, it's good coverage by Carrington. He's the biggest corner they have at 6 feet one. Carrington's on the inside. Ball's thrown up high. They give Daniels a chance to make a play. Again, Carrington doesn't turn around. There's no such thing as face guarding. Ruled a safe play by the refs.
So Brinza on for the 25-yard field goal attempt to give the Irish the lead. Brinza from 25 gets up, and it is good. So Kyle Brinza kicks the field goal. It's a three-point tenuous Notre Dame lead. Threes are wild here. Notre Dame has 30. 3:03 left in the fourth quarter. A three-point lead. After kicking his third field goal, Kyle Brinza has it teed up for the kickoff. And Marion Grice will be deep. And Brinza drives it deep into the end zone. So ASU begins from the 25-yard line. Arizona State from the 25-yard line. Their last touchdown drive, 75 yards, and there's a sack by Shembo, his third of the game. Prince Shembo with a sack of Taylor Kelly.
The entire line was slanting to the left, and for some reason they didn't pick up Shembo. Here he is. They're all slanting left. Nice job by him staying home on the backside.
Say the last touchdown drive only took 2 minutes and 20 seconds for ASU as Grice out of the backfield draws a crowd. They push him back from the 22-yard line.
Grice made no attempt to get out of bounds when I thought he had a chance to.
7-yard gain. Third down and long. Short hop by Ozier as Tuitt was bearing down on Taylor Kelly.
Nice job by Tuitt. He's working on 74, the left guard right there. Douglas gets an edge, keeps pushing. Pretty good movement skills for the 325 pounds, Stephon Tuitt.
So on fourth down and 13 and only a minute 59 on the clock.
Wow.
It appears that Arizona State is going to go for it.
With three timeouts left, they don't want to give the football back to Notre Dame because they haven't been able to stop their run game.
Fourth down and 13. Here's Kelly. His pass downfield. Intercepted. Farley. And down the sideline and out of bounds with a flag down.
Yeah. They're going to get a block in the back. Yeah, I thought he telegraphed this throw to Jalen Strong all day long. Farley doing a nice job coming over the top.
And during the return, there was an illegal block in the back by number 38 of the intercepting team. It's 10 yards from the spot of the foul. First down.
So it was an illegal block in the back.
Yep. Farley's the overhang defender, just cuts in front. Taylor Kelly stared it down. I thought that he should have gotten down. Here comes the block in the back right there.
For Farley, his second interception of the season. And a big one. There's the block in the back
by Joe Schmidt.
Midfield now, they'll go to Mr. Dependable, the Texan Cam McDaniel. Of course, Arizona State knows that as well.
Quick timeout.
ASU now with two timeouts remaining. Cam McDaniel remains the running back. Gets the handoff, does McDaniel. It's a yard. Timeout, ASU. They got their money's worth, it turned out, at AT&T Stadium tonight. Here's the third down play. And he is going to throw the ball. Reese will throw it away. And that stops the clock.
What?
129. I'm scratching my head on that one.
Yeah, I don't get that one. I understand that you know you're going to probably get a one-on-one, but I don't see the percentages there. And it looks like Brian Kelly's not very happy with that.
So now it's fourth down, and Arizona State still has a timeout in its pocket.
I just don't understand why you don't force them to use their last timeout. There's a minute 29 left. Should have had it under a minute.
Brents have picked up the low snap, and it's a high, towering punt, not that deep. Oh, and they let it bounce. He should have made the fair catch. Instead, Notre Dame will down it at the 1 yard line. Whoa. That does not make any sense.
No.
There's two scratch your head plays.
I don't get that at all. You have to protect the football there. You have to fair catch the football. I mean, I don't understand what's happening right there. Robert Nelson. One timeout. Double stack receivers each way. I'd be alert for double pass, all kinds of gadget stuff.
Taylor Kelly from his own end zone wings it downfield and it's picked off for a touchdown. That is Dan. Brenza, extra point. And Dan Fox with the interception return for the touchdown, intercepting Taylor Kelly. There's Fox, who scores the touchdown on the INT, and it's a 10-point game.
And I think with Jarrett Grace out with an injury earlier, I thought Fox and Calabrese did a heck of a job. Read the eyes, drive on the football. Tom, you could have caught that. Now, you might not have done that, but you could have caught it. Really good pressure again by Tuitt. I thought this was against a really dynamic offense. With the exception of one or two plays, Tom, I thought it was their best defensive effort of the season.
Kelly being chased. Leads it to Zier. And so with a minute one on the clock, don't forget your local news will be up next, followed by Saturday Night Live, except on the West Coast. Cyrus, both the host and the musical guest tonight. Kelly's pass over the head of Bryce. It's incomplete. And the clock down to 56 seconds.
Pretty hard to reconcile watching the tape of this offense against USC, Wisconsin, and then seeing what a good job Notre Dame did. Very similar to what Stanford did with them.
Kelly rolling out. Pass caught at midfield by Ozier. Just across midfield. Stops the clock at 47 seconds, 22-yard gain. So the Irish, after that disheartening defeat, turnover plague at home against Oklahoma a week ago, bounce back against a good ranked ASU team.
Yeah, they were 22 in the AP, right, Tom?
Yep. Kelly steps up. His pass is caught by Smith. Cameron Smith, no, by DJ Foster. As they get into the heart of their Pac-12 schedule, Kelly will scramble and run out of bounds. That'll stop the clock at 31. And we told you for Notre Dame, a bye week is upcoming. And then USC comes to South Bend. Then they'll be at Air Force, Navy at home, at Pitt, BYU at home, and then at fifth-ranked Stanford to close the season.
And that is a good football team coached by David Shaw out there in Palo Alto.
Kelly escapes for the moment. Throws incomplete. Intended for Richard Smith. Tommy Reese, in the face of all that criticism, passes 17 for 38 tonight, 279 yards, three touchdowns, and the one interception that went for a score against them. TJ Jones had eight receptions, 135 yards. Daniels, four receptions, 67 yards. The tight ends, Nicholas and Koyak, had a touchdown reception each. Atkinson carried 18 times, 54 yards. McDaniel, 14 carries, 82 yards. There's the catch by Grice for the touchdown, ASU. And Grice with another touchdown to add to his sparkling total. But only 11 seconds remain on the clock.
Talked about throwing into the boundary all day long. We talked about back shoulder stuff. Grice out of the backfield working on a linebacker. Calabrese throw is perfect on the back shoulder. They do that as well as any team I've seen in college football.
Zales boots the extra point through the uprights, and so with 11 seconds left, Arizona State will set up for the onside kick.
Now, Tom, I watched them a couple weeks ago in their Stanford game, and they climbed back into it. They were down 29-0 at half. They got it within 11 late in the fourth, and they had an onside kick attempt. And they do a little, they did in this particular game, they lined six up on one side, four on the other, and then just before the kicker was to kick it, they shifted a couple guys over and completely shifted the direction of the kick. So you've got to be very aware, if you're Brian Kelly and the special teams, be very, very aware of what this team's going to do.
And the Sun Devils were able to score that last touchdown without using their final timeout. Well, we told you the Sun Devils were explosive, but Notre Dame made it maybe a little too easy for them that last time. Seven plays, 75 yards. You know how long it took? 57 seconds. And they didn't use their timeout.
Now, remember, you have to have four players at least on each side of the kicker. So there's a collection of three down here. Let's see if there's any rotation. Either four down there.
Here's the onside kick. It's up for grabs.
A heck of a job by the kicker.
And Notre Dame has recovered.
Watch how they do that. This is intentional for the kicker to kick it straight ahead, and he's going to go after it himself. And that's a good job. The ball's free. Grice almost comes up with it.
Not sure who finally came up with it for Notre Dame. I think it might have been TJ Jones. What a game he had. So here's the victory formation. Tommy Reese takes a knee. And a hard-fought victory for the Irish of Notre Dame, who go to 4-2 on the season, bouncing back from the loss to Oklahoma, 37-34. Another Shamrock Series victory for the Irish of Notre Dame. For Mike Mayock and Alex Flanagan, this is Tom Hammond saying so long from AT&T Stadium.